I grew up on fairy tales. And I love fairy tales for their sort of bite-size everything, bite-size romance and danger and exploration and adventure and coming home again, and all those things that happen in a fairy tale just happen like that. And I also think they're very important tales because they have lasted so long in an oral tradition. So that means something about them was important enough that a mother wanted to tell it to her daughter, and then she wanted to tell it to her daughter, and it lasted that long. So I really honor those tales. But the ones that I choose to retell are the ones that bother me the most. The ones that are just sort of beautiful on their own, I'm not actually interested in retelling. The ones that get under my skin and make me ask a lot of questions, and just like, but why, but how, but no, you haven't told me enough. And that's where I get the motivation to retell it. The Goose Girl was one of my favorites when I was younger, but it was just too mysterious, and there was so much unknown there that I wanted to explore. Maid Maleen was the one that I actually discovered later in life, and I retold for Book of a Thousand Days. And that one, I was motivated because in the original tale, a maid is imprisoned in a tower with her mistress, and for 7 years, because the mistress wouldn't marry the man her father wanted her to. Well, after they get out of the tower, the Grimm's brothers don't tell you anything else about the maid. And it made me so angry. I was like, she spent 7 years in this tower and we don't even get, you just drop her? I was just furious with them. So I felt like I needed to tell her story. And that's where Book of a Thousand Days came out. And then Rapunzel's just the most irritating fairy tale of all time. She's in the tower. Does she try to escape? We don't know. The prince comes and discovers her, climbs up her hair, and that has to hurt. And then he leaves. And when he comes back, does he bring a ladder or a rope or anything useful? No, he brings raw silk, which he then has her weave into her own ladder. Like, and he comes and goes quite often, and they end up having, you know, love children. So you know what he was going there for. He's either like a really immoral person or just not very smart. And I find this so irritating. So our Rapunzel, I had to take it to the other extreme. She's in the Old West, she uses her braid as whip and lasso, gets out of her tower and goes and kicks some butt. And I find her so much more appealing. It is a huge revision of the original, but I felt like it needed to happen.